past few budgets, sir. Sir, as someone has rightly said, tax should be extracted like the honeybee extracts honey from flowers. Presently, sir, this government is extracting tax like blood being sucked by leeches, especially of tax-compliant taxpayers. At least under new tax regime, the threshold should be linked to inflation. This will go a long way, sir, in demonstrating that the tax legislation is fair, and that in turn will improve compliance. Sir, block assessment is sought to be reintroduced. Reassessment provisions are again sought to be tinkered. When the Parliament, in its wisdom, had done away with block assessment, proceedings for such cases, where is the need to revisit again? These frequent changes, sir, in such an important piece of legislation, which are unnecessary, unwarranted, will lead to avoidable litigation and further burden the courts. Sir, when concession was given decades back only on the basis of additional levy, can the concession be withdrawn while the additional levy continues? This is backstabbing, sir. This is exactly what has been proposed. STT was levied on buying and selling of equity shares and mutual fund units, accompanied with reduction in the tax rates on capital gains such securities, sir. Sir, now the rate of capital gain tax is proposed to be increased while the STT remains. People lose faith, sir, in the government with such step. For example, sir, LTCG on equity shares, equity-oriented funds, existing is 10% over 1 lakh. Now, proposed is 12.5% over 1.25 lakhs. STCG on equity shares, UF, is 15%. Proposed is 20%. Sir, the LTCG gain tax on other assets is prima facie being reduced. Sir, however, the benefit of indexation is being withdrawn. Again, this is a retrograde step. The CII method was a well-thought and has been working fine for the past several decades. Why repair something which is not being broken, sir? I'll give an example, sir. Purchase of a flat in 2001, existing is 15 lakhs, proposed is 15 lakhs. Index cost, sir, is 54, is capital gains tax is 20.55 lakhs, proposed is 60 lakhs. Capital gain tax is 4.11 lakhs, proposed is 7.50 lakhs. This is an 82% increase in tax liability, sir. In fact, in all the new tax regime, the rate of 12.5% without indexation should be optional. As announced by the Finance Minister on August 6, it is not enough, sir, if it is made applicable prospective from July 23rd. The option should be left to taxpayer even for new assets purchase. Sir, where is this need for this new section? Section 194T, TDS at 10% interest on capital remuneration to partners at ₹20,000. The purpose, sir, of TDS is to ensure that the income does not escape taxation. In the case of firm, there is no such risk. The remuneration to working partner is typically calculated at the time of preparation of financial statements. How will the taxpayer comply with TDS deadlines, sir? Sir, now another important point, sir. Section 206C1F. Presently, TCS at 10% motor cars above is 10 lakhs. Now, January 1, 2025, luxury goods are notified rupees 10 lakhs. This is unnecessary harassment, sir. You are not improving your machinery instead of putting burden on business people. This is not ease of business. This is you're putting more hardship, sir. In GST on health insurance, sir, premium collected in 23-24 was 8,263 crores, madam. I request the government remove this GST on health insurance and life insurance. You know, it should be waived so that more people come under the coverage. It is the government duty to provide medical treatment, madam. Madam, social, another important point which I want to bring, GST, what about GST on petroleum products? Are the state governments ready for it? Madam, social sector schemes overall 25% decrease in allocation, inflation adjusted to last decade. Sarva Siksha Abhiyan 18% decline, Rashtriya Madhyamik Abhiyan 9% decline, ICDS 34% decline, Mission Aganwadi 5% decline, PM Poshan scheme 45% decline, and in public distribution, madam, 6.61 in 2019-20 declined to 4.24 in 2023-24. Even if we combine Prime Minister Garib Kalyan Yojana, the decline is still lower than 19-20 as opposed to the total budget. Madam, in Ministry of Minority Affairs, the budget this year is same as 2012 and 13. The unit cost of post-matric and pre-matric scholarship for minorities has not changed since 2007 and 8. 1 minute, madam, I'm concluding. Has not changed since 2007 and 8. What that 80 rupees, 100 rupees still continuing? Madam, Ministry of Minority Affairs budget should have been increased to nearly 8,000 crore. That has not been done. Madam, 15th of August, we are going to celebrate our Yom-e-Azadi. In Yom-e-Azadi, madam, I'm reminded of Maulana Abdullah Khairabadi, who said that when I die, you come to my grave and inform me that India has got independence. That was done. Now, what will Mahmudul Hassan, Hussain Ahmad Madni, will be saying if they're right now? They'll be saying that we didn't live in Malta jail for 8 months to see this day that our Waqf properties will be taken by this dictator government, madam. I condemn this law. Thank you very much, madam.
माननीय सदस्य